gadgets and gizmos aplenty. I've got who's its and what's its galore. You want thingamabobs? I got 20. But who cares? No big deal. I want more. This trove, treasures untold. How many wonders can one cavern hold? Looking around here, you think, sure, she's got everything. I've got gadgets and gizmos aplenty. I've got who's its and what's its galore. You want thingamabobs? I got 20. But who cares? No big deal. I want more.
Is everyone in the room or?
I've got losing.
Can you hear me, Brian?
Yes.
I think we're okay to start.
Okay, great. Super. Thanks. Not a problem. So good morning. Thanks for coming to my session. Today I want to talk about gadgets and gizmos. I'm on the faculty at St. Elizabeth University, and I been in the field of assistive tech for over 35 years now. And I've always been attracted and love playing with gadgets and gizmos. I guess that's just who I am. And so over the last couple of years, especially during COVID, I was able to engage with a lot of different companies that were manufacturing and producing some really interesting gadgets and gizmos that can really help students with learning challenges. So I'd like to share some of those with you. If you do have questions, I'm glad to, you can entertain them in the chat. So I think, you know, some of my goals are to introduce you some of the tools that at least I feel are relatively easy to use. Of course, a little bit of training and onboarding is always needed. For a lot of the students I was working with, it became a revelation for a lot of parents during COVID, just how much assistance their children needed when doing work independently. And so some of these tools were quite effective to helping students, especially in the area of reading, to become more independent. And hopefully some of the tools remove some of that cognitive load, and also with that, some of the frustration that some of these students experience. So why gadgets and gizmos? Well, one is because I enjoy using them, but they're personal, they're easy to use. They're generally pretty portable, lightweight. So they're easy to stick in a backpack, a purse, a desk. The big thing for me is that they definitely will help increase the independence of students who have learning challenges, and I think that is key. In many cases, some of these tools will integrate with other tools, meaning other applications, web applications, Chromebooks, Macs, PCs, as well as applications. And some of these are pretty, pack a lot of power considering the size and what they do. And for the most part, though, I do have some that are a little bit more expensive. Most of them are of lower cost, which is great. So the first group that I want to talk to you about are smart paper devices. So these are generally lightweight and portable. They're good for for free form lectures. Some of them even have handwriting recognition using the accompanying applications. Some of them come with pre-formatted writing templates, like the one I will show you. But the Rocketbook has a Cornell note-taking template built in. And also the notes are shareable. Some of the cons is these are, because they're paper-based or writing-based, they're dependent on handwriting. So kids who are really dysgraphic may not do well with these solutions. There's no audio supports. And of course, the loss of the notebook, if the student didn't scan, could be devastating. So, the first entry is on the left, and of course I don't have enough time to demonstrate everything, but I have used the Hamlin has notebooks using optic paper. It's a really good high quality paper, and it comes with the free Scribsby app that lets the student scan and share the information. On the right book, on the right side, you might be a little bit more familiar with the rocket book. This is the rocket book orbit. On the top, you'll see two little metal configurations. These are actually magnets, so it lets you quickly insert a different like pad of templates or papers from line to dot grid. The most important part is the student writes their notes with the Pilot Friction pen. And then when they're done, down over here, you can see these seven icons. These are destinations that you have preset for the student. So if the student takes the notes, they put an X in the rocket. That might be when the page is scanned, you could set this up so this, if this was a science notes, this can go into the science folder in the student's Google Drive. This might be math, this could be English. So it really allows for the student to not only take notes, but store them and organize them, which is really great. So what I'm going to do now is I am going to just quickly show you. So this is what the rocket book looks like. I don't know why it's not an angle. It's kind of strange. This is the orbit. And then at the bottom of the page, you see you have the, let me just say, I think I may have hit the rotate. Let's see. There we go. So when you scan using the app, which I'm going to do in a second for you just to show you. So I'm going to move. This is my iPhone, and what I'm going to do is just put this over, and you can see that it captured the page. You can see page one there. And what I can do is just hit the next, and you can see this will transcribe, and this will also, I had set it up to send it to my email. So it's sending it to my email, it's complete. So I'm doing this live. This is not a demo. I mean, it's a demo, but I just want to show you. It probably will come in a second. So there's the scan. So you can see this is the PDF of the scan. And not only does it do that, but did it do that? Let me go back here for a reason. But here is the handwriting transcription. So you can see how well it did it. So I can then take this and bring this into any text editor and continue writing. But again, the nice part about this system is now that I've got the notes, scanned, I can now take a wet cloth and just spritz it with a little water, take a cloth, clean it, and I can reuse this. So if you're working with kids with organizational difficulties, especially around notes, this might be something to try. And like I was saying, this one, the Orbit, is nice because you can purchase these pads. Some of them have lines, some dot grid, and then with the magnets, they just affix to it. So it could be a nice solution for kids that have trouble with organization. The other thing too, if you're working in schools where they're using traditional whiteboards, the Rocketbook has a solution called Beacons. This is a $15 solution. There are these orange triangular pieces of almost like plastic foam, and they affix to the whiteboard. And then the students can use the scanning application from Rocketbook and capture and file the information as if they were using their own personal Rocketbook. This has been so successful. I mean, just as an example, Stockton University is using this to as a way to provide notes to students. They can take it, just use the app and take a picture and file it. And this is a pretty inexpensive solution at about $15 for four of those triangular corners. So note-taking, the note-taking conundrum, a lot of the students we work with have trouble with note-taking, and it could be because they have trouble with paying attention or simultaneously processing the content or not knowing what to write down. And of course, fine motor skills gets in the way, as well as organizing the information. A lot of the students I work with, especially high school and college, but more so in college as they get to that point in their career, is the anxiety level around note-taking can become quite severe. So if we can provide them with some tools, we might be able to alleviate their anxiety and hopefully help them focus on the content. So one of the things a lot of the colleges are moving away from peer note-taking is expensive. It could be unreliable depending on the note-taker. It also creates dependence, which can negatively impact on learning. So one of the trends that I think all of us are seeing, and I know it's a challenge in the public schools, but there's a lot of advantages to using audio. It provides that safety net if the student misses something. It enables them to review their notes at the end of the day. They also don't feel the need to have to write everything down. And a lot of these technologies can be used both with words or images. And of course, there's never enough time in the day. So a lot of these technologies can abbreviate the amount of time students would may, you know, need to review lectures. So I want to talk a little bit about smart pens. There are basically two companies that are manufacturing them. On the left, that's the Neo Dymo. It's a company, Neo Lab, which makes Neo smart pens, is on the left. And the LifeScribe company on the right. And I'll go over some more information. These are some of the models, the LifeScribe Symphony, LifeScribe Ager. Those rely on Bluetooth to an iPad, iPhone, or an Android-based phone. And many of us were looking forward to, and it was just recently released, is the LifeScribe Echo. It's actually the LifeScribe Echo 2. And the difference between these two models is the two on the left do not have a microphone or speaker, but rely on the speaker and the microphone on the device, so whether it's an iPhone or an Android phone. The LifeScribe Echo 2 has both a small LED window, which provides feedback to the student. It also has a microphone and speaker built in. So this is the little dot is the microphone, and that is the speaker, and then you have an LED window. So a student can go into the class, if they're allowed to record audio, turn this on. They don't need any other device to record the audio and begin taking their notes. So this one was just released maybe 4 or 5 months ago and should be readily available. So with the LifeScribe pen, so you understand how it works, it records the handwriting and audio. It also allows teachers or even students to create what pen casts, which are little mini videos. And you can always back up your notes to Mac or Windows. So the LifeScribe Echo, as I said, has the microphone built into the pen. It also has Bluetooth support for headsets so that students can listen to it privately, so that's an option as well. The LifeScribe Eager and Symphony, they're thin pen design. They utilize Bluetooth to connect to the iPhone or Android, and then they rely on desktop software for Mac and Windows for backup. So this is just a demo to give you an idea of how this works.
What I'd like to do is show you how we can use the LifeScribe pen for note-taking in the classroom. The first thing I'm going to do is I'm just going to turn it on, and you see it's starting up. To take notes, I'm just going to tap on the record button, and I'm going to make believe I'm sitting in my science class and my teacher's asking me to bring in some materials for a science experiment that we're going to be doing. So first thing I do is I click record. And now what I'm going to do is I'm just going to write a science experiment list. So the first thing I heard was need to bring in some salt. And then my teacher asked me to bring in mineral water and also bring in a plastic container. And the last thing was to bring in some straws, and these were straws that were bendable. Once I'm finished taking the notes, I'm going to hit stop. Now, when I go home, if I want to listen to my notes again, I could just tap on each one of these, and then you would hear the audio note.
The thing I heard was need to bring in some salt, and then my teacher asked me to bring in mineral water, and also bring in a plastic container. And the last thing was to bring in some straws, and these were straws that were bendable. Once I'm finished taking the notes, I'm going to hit.
So you can see that the student can always go back and refer back to the audio note that was recorded. In a couple of seconds, this information is going to be synced to my Evernote account, where I can also view it and listen to it.
Oh, I want to do that.
Listen to it.
Sorry about that. Okay. So what I'm going to do now, I just wanted to show you the new Echo 2. So this is the new Echo 2 pen. I'm just going to turn it on. You'll see that it says LiveScribe. And then what I can do is using the one caveat is that you have to use the paper that they provide. So if I wanted to start my recording down over here, there's a little icon. I click on this. So now it says it's recording, and now I can take my notes. So basically what this does is it timestamps everything. So even if there's something important that I want to record, the other thing too is sometimes when I work with students, I might set up some sort of legend so that they don't feel like they even have to write words. So if the teacher says this is going to be on the test, they can put a T, or it's important to review this information, they can use an R. When I'm done, I hit the stop, and then I can come back later at the day and just tap.
What this does is it timestamps everything. Both they can put a T, or it's important to review this information, they can use an R. When I'm done, I...
So that, basically, a student can go in with the pen and a notebook, start taking notes, as long as they're close to the source of the instruction, and then they should be good to go. So this, I want to say, I think this runs somewhere about $150, give or take, and you can get it on the LiveScribe website. So that is that solution. And let's go continue. What happened here? Let me just... So the other company is Neolab, and they make a number of different smart pen models. Just vary in price. They're anywhere from $69 to probably $150. This is the least expensive at around $69. These can record out of the box both the ink, and also they can do voice notes, which allows you to pen audio while the student is taking notes, but it doesn't really timestamp per se. If you're a pen lover, Lamy recently came out with a joint collaboration with the Neo company to create a Lamy-based pen, which is pretty iconic in the pen industry. But I just want to show you. I'm going to get my document camera up. So this is the Neo Smart Pen. It's thin design. I take the cap off and it automatically turns on. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to put my phone in, and I'm going to link the note. There we go. Okay. So what this is the Neo, this is the app that that runs, and hopefully it'll. So if I wanted to, I could write, you know, the NJ Tech Summit. It's kind of weird. It's not starting up. And so right now I'm not recording any audio. I can just record my notes. What happens is even if the student were to come in and they didn't have their iPhone, what would happen is that it would automatically, the next time I opened up the app, it would actually link it and transfer the notes. It does have the capability of having a voice note as well. I'm not sure if too much is going on here, but we'll move on to the next. So the Neo Smart, they use Bluetooth. They connect to the iPhone. It also uses Neo Studio that allows you to also share your handwriting in the cloud. So I'll just do a quick little demo.
You can take notes while recording. Tap the More icon on the page menu and tap the Start Recording button. When the recording starts, the recording signs will be indicated. If you take notes while recording, your writing data will be saved with audio. Press the record bar and press the stop button to complete recording. Now let's replay the voice memo. Tap the More icon at the top of the page and tap the recording icon to see your voice memo. Select a voice memo and press the play button to replay. The part without writings only plays the voice, and the part recorded with writings plays with the voice. You can play back the writing time lapse you made with demo. You can replay what was said at the time the note was written. Save and share the writing time lapse as a video file.
I'm going to go back in and just kind of show you live. So here's the notes. Let me just get the my phone up again. So now when I'm in the I'm using the pen, you can see that as I write my notes, it automatically comes up in the application itself. And then one of the other features I have is I can start the audio. So this will take voice notes and record them. And it's a great, actually, I use this a lot when I'm doing evaluations. And it's great because when I come back and I have to write my report, I can listen to the student reading the passage, answering questions. When I want to stop, I'm just going to tap on that and do that. And then if I go back here, I have voice memo replay. And then you can
start the audio. So this will take voice notes.
So you see is that it actually highlights the text that I took the voice notes. And I can move, what's nice is I can also move this the slider
a lot when
to whatever point I want in this. So it works really well. And I can also share this as also as handwriting transcription as well. So if I go back here, I can click on that and I hit transcribe and you'll see that, it cut out so much of it, but it can also transcribe as well, which is really nice. So this is a really nice system if you're looking for an alternative to it. There's also, when looking at, this is not exactly smart paper, but some of you may be familiar with the Boogie Board, and they have a solution called Carbon Copy Pen. And what this is, it actually uses one of the Neo pens, but it has a stylus in it. And you write on the Boogie Board and everything that you write gets transmitted to their app. And then you can share it to cloud services. So if you want to move away from paper, this might be a solution that you can take a look at. So that's what it looks like. So the students write and then they tap the pen on the little dot at the bottom and it transfers over to the app on the Android, iPhone, or iPad. So wanted to talk a little bit. Another solution from Neo Smart Pen is the RICO, and the RICO stands for recorder. And so this basically is a very similar solution to the LiveScribe Pen, but it takes advantage of a little audio recorder that can be used with their pens. So the student would basically use the recorder and then with the pen, and then they would be good to go. Let me just quit adding this. So they use a digital pen, they can use the recording device with the notebook, and then whatever they write gets automatically synced with it. So these are the components the student would need to go into the classroom with. They need the digital notebook, which has the watermark on it, the RICO, which is the recorder, and then they have the digital pen. In this case, it's the Dymo. The recorder costs $69. It's a digital audio recorder, which also has some of the benefits that even if you've done the recording, you can plug it into your Mac or PC and drag the audio files off. And then actually you can send it to a service and they can be transcribed as well. I just want to show you. So This is the audio recorder. This is the Dymo pen. These two are linked. And what I'm going to do is hit the record button. So now it's recording. So now I can use this also to timestamp my notes in the classroom. It's also good for, drawing images. So this is the nucleus of the cell. This is the cell wall. And when I'm done, I could just hit stop. And now when the student goes back to the classroom, they could.
So good for, you know, even, you know, drawing images of, does the cell wall also to timestamp my notes.
So what's
in the classroom?
So what's nice about this is it's relatively lightweight. And again, it timestamps. So a student can go with any one of the different notebooks and record, have that backup audio, which would be really great for a note-taking. Any questions at this point? So just students that just want to record audio, I recently started using this one. This is a Sony. It runs around $50. You may even find it cheaper on Amazon. What's really nice about this particular model is it does have different scenarios for, depending upon where the student is recording that can be set with the device. But the big thing is it has a USB port built in. So after the student records the session, they could plug it in and actually this mounts as a hard drive, just like a thumb drive. They can pull the audio file off, play it on their computer, or they could use a service like Otter AI or even Word Online or Caption.ed. They can drop the file into those services and get transcription. So this is a really nice solution for students that just want to audio record. And again, this might be a better solution than the students using their phone, which might be distracting, in the classroom or may not be allowed in the classroom. So these are relatively inexpensive solutions that can do the job of recording audio. And again, with a lot of these different services, it's easy for students to get transcription out of them. I was just on a conference call with Otter.ai, and they have a service. It runs, I want to say, maybe $20 a month that will allow students to record transcribe their notes, unlimited number of hours. So that's sort of pretty cool. What's the amount of time for the RICO? Top of my head, I believe it's something like 16 hours. I think it's like 16 hours of audio. So the whole idea is, you use it and then you plug it into your Mac or your PC, and then you basically archive them on your computer. So just for those of you that might not be aware, if you have an Office 365 account, you can transcribe audio with the Word Online, which is, and they give you 300 hours a month. Here's a quick little demo.
Hi, this is Dr. Friedlander, and I'd like to show you a really incredible feature that was just added to Word, which is part of Office 365. Right now, this is running on the web version, but my understanding is that this will run on the desktop version of Word 365. This feature gives students the ability to take audio files and transcribe them. So I want to show you how we do this. So I'm on Word Online. I click on the down arrow here, and you can see that I now have dictate and transcribe. I'm going to click transcribe. And now what I am going to do is I'm going to upload an audio file that I actually created earlier on my iPhone. As you can see, this is a M4A file, but it will accept WAV or MP4 or M4A or MP3 files. I click open. It's now transcribing the audio, and in a couple of seconds, you will see the text appear in that panel. We could have only dreamed this feature a couple of years ago. Now Microsoft is making this possible. It's almost done uploading to OneDrive. And you can see this was just a short audio recording. I can play each one by clicking.
This is really exciting, the ability to transcribe audio right within Microsoft Word.
What's nice too is that this will transcribe speakers. So if I wanted to, I could type my name. But if you were interviewing someone, you'd be able to change the names. And you can see I'm going to change them for all and hit confirm. And now you can see on the speaker. And then if I want to add the text to Microsoft Word, I click add all. And now you can see that all the text is here and it's totally editable, which is really fantastic. So students that are recording audio in their classrooms as an accommodation can now take the audio files and transcribe them in Microsoft Word. This certainly opens up all kinds of possibilities.
So that's a relatively new feature, but definitely an exciting one. So the future of note-taking devices, for those of you that have used Kindles, a lot of companies are moving to using e-ink devices. Some of the devices that I've used are the paper from Cork Logic, MobiScribe, which is about the size of a Kindle, a small one, and then the Remarkable 2, which maybe you have seen. I'm just going to open up my document camera. So this is the Remarkable 2. You can see you have some memo, you have some menus going down the left, and you can see I'm writing with a stylus. This has a tremendous writing experience. And this is also in a non-distracting environment. There is no, you can connect it to Wi-Fi to back up, to share, to do some other things. There's no notifications. It's not like an iPad or a computer. You will not get any notifications. You can also use this as to annotate, bring in PDFs. You can also use it for teaching online. So you can work with PDFs. You can also you can share the Remarkable over Zoom when teaching. So I often might use this as almost like a whiteboard. There's no glare. The writing experience is unbelievable. And what's nice is that, you know, everything gets stored. You can see that you can have folders, you can organize your information. But again, for students that are easily distracted or you want to work with them to help them organize their handwritten notes, as long as that's the best method for them, this might be a technology you want to, you know, take a look at. The price for these varies. I'd have to say the Remarkable 2 is like is in the league of Apple products. It is a very premium product, but has a lot of really nice features. So this is definitely the wave of the future. You might see a lot of business people starting to use them. So this basically replaces the legal pad. It has some other bells and whistles, but it really is provides a really nice note-taking writing experience with minimal distractions. So I'm going to put that over here. So the other devices that have sort of come into their own over the last couple of years are these personal readers or scanning devices. And like I shared with you before, these were really helpful during COVID. To help students become more independent, when they're reading. So the first one I want to show you is this is the C Pen reader. It's got a small display, and you just go across. But you can see that it scanned the text in. The algorithms have gotten a lot better. Of course, this relies on some, you know, better fine motor skills. And I'll do it one more line. So just like a highlighter. You also have dictionary supports. This one also has you can plug a headset into it, which is nice. And I'm going to move on to the next one. Let me just move this. So so the next one is the scan marker reader, which like this. So this one is a little bit different in that it requires a screen, and that screen could be an iPhone, an iPad, a computer, a Mac, PC, or Chromebook. So I'm going to connect this to that. Next. So you can do right or left-handed. And so now I can start scanning.
Clip will offer some assistance with a few simple points that will help you get the most.
I need that. Let's see. So this company offers this, offers this window. And so what, so students that have fine motor problems, they can stick this in here and just go across the page. So it really helps guide. It's a guide, and you can see how that was done. Let me get at it. Okay. So this is what the interface looks like in the full version, and I'm just going to do that again. So there it is. I can if I could have done this, but let's do that.
Buck didn't read the newspapers, but
so. This has really nice text to speech. We can customize the speed. We can make it slower.
Thank you for choosing scan marker.
I can hit that.
Buck didn't read the newspapers, but
You can also change the language. Again, if you if I wanted to, let's do newspapers. It also has a dictionary with text-to-speech support.
A publication, usually published daily or weekly.
And it also has translational capabilities as well. So if I wanted to scan in other languages, on the computer, you can easily have English at the top, Spanish at the bottom. You can do that. You can really fine tune and customize the experience, for the student. So if you have, iPads or you allow students to use iPhones or even Chromebooks, this will work with Chromebooks, Macs, PCs. This might be a really nice solution. And then there are a number of Chinese companies that are manufacturing these devices. This one actually has a touch. This one actually has a touch screen. And they're selling these as translational devices, but if you set it to English, I could just click and go across, and you can see that it read.
Buck didn't read the newspapers. But
so this does a really good job as well. There's a lot of companies that are selling these in my my slide deck. This is from a company, I think Yodao, but a number of companies are selling these as translational. You can go from English to Spanish, you can go from English to Chinese, and these provide a nice platform. What's nice about this one is the way this is set up is I can go right, if a student, did he get it?
Alaska.
If a student doesn't know one particular word, they can just press right before the word and it will scan it and capture it and then read it aloud. So again, these are some really handy tools for individuals who need that kind of support. So one of the most innovative tools that has come out is the so running out of time is the OrCam Read, and this is probably the most expensive tool that I will show you. But this is real innovation. This runs about $1,900. Originally, this came out for individuals who were visually impaired, and they refocused the product for individuals who have reading disabilities. Just to give you an idea,
75% charged.
Just a sort of context of 25 years ago, I met Ray Kurzweil. Who developed the reading machine, or some of you may be familiar with Kurzweil. He showed what was the development of this tool. He had a Nokia smartphone with a Canon digital camera, and he took the picture with the Canon and the Nokia at that time, which was one of the more powerful telephones that was developed in Europe, did the OCR. And so now basically be able to package this in about a 5-inch device. So what I'm going to do is just take a picture.
Chapter 1, trouble for dogs like Buck. Buck didn't read the newspapers, but if he had read them, he would have known that trouble was brewing for dogs like him. Gold had been discovered in Alaska, and now thousands of men were rushing north, hoping to get rich. These men needed dogs, and the dogs they wanted were dogs like Buck.
So you heard it took the entire page, picture of the entire page, and I don't have time today, but you can slow the rate of speech for the text to speech. There are different modes. You can also students can use their Bluetooth earbuds to listen to this privately. The other nice thing is that this does not need an internet connection to work. So it's basically independent of anything else. So a student can be rest assured they come in, they can basically take a picture of the page and read it. So this is probably one of the most innovative tools that I'm using. And just a couple more fun tools, maybe more so for the classroom. There are a number of these thermal printers. They're fairly inexpensive, run about $50. And teachers and students can use it to output notes. No ink is required, so that it makes it really easy to use. I'll show you. And again, you may come up with some really interesting ways to use it. I'm just going to turn it on. They're pretty straightforward devices. So students can create to-do lists. Teachers might be able to actually create some engaging materials with it. So let's see. Thank you for attending my workshop. Okay. So you can see I just printed that using this, the app over here, but there are templates. So you can see, teachers or even students can, can do it for goal setting, lists, tasks, and you could print out anything from your library. So, and they also sell, if you, you know, if you want adhesive thermal paper, so that you can then just peel off the back and stick it on a notebook, which is really really nice. So you can do some interesting things with that. And I'll put a link, and if you email me, I'll be glad to send you. So for those of you, this is a last interesting device. This is the Steno Mask. And it's actually, it's a microphone. You might see some court stenographers use this. The whole idea is to give students privacy when they're in the classroom and want to do dictation using, you know, whether it be Microsoft Word or in Google Docs. This connects to the computer via USB port. The student puts it over their mouth, and then it muffles the sound so they can dictate privately. It also reduces background noise. So that's another interesting device that I've experienced and used. So I'm just gonna. So there's my contact information. I'll swing back to the first. I'll swing back to the first slide, so that you can, let me just go back here. I have a QR code, and if you scan it, I will give you access.
Treasures untold. This trove.
So I want to, thank you for coming to my session, and you can have access to my slide deck by scanning that, and then I will give you permission to do that, and then you'll have access to all these great tools. If you have any questions, I am available for school consultations or any questions about using any of these technologies. Are there any questions before we kind of wrap up?
I don't believe so, Brian. We've asked. Thank you, though, very much.
Okay. Have a great day, everyone. Hope to see you soon.
Thank you.